Hi, and welcome to this new video about the AdSense Management API. I'm José Alzárrega.
And I'm Sergio Gomes.
This session is meant to be a getting started guide, so we'll cover everything from APIs in general to the new features in version 1.4. So if you're familiar with the API, you can jump to the more advanced topics using the links that you will find in the description of this video if you're watching from YouTube.
So we should start with a little introduction to AdSense. AdSense is Google's program for publishers to earn revenue by displaying advertising on their websites. And the way the AdSense Management API ties in with this is it allows you access to your AdSense data programmatically. This includes all of your inventory data, which would be ad units, ad clients, channels, all of that information, as well as the ability to run reports on your data, and other smaller features such as the ability to list your alerts.
Okay. So what is an API? Let's see an example. Imagine you want to create a widget for your smartphone that checks the weather. You'll need somewhere to fetch this information from. In this example, we query this fake weather API by specifying a city in the query parameter. If we open that with a browser, we get something like this, a response with a known structure that we can easily parse. Usually, requests and responses use XML or JSON as container formats. So let's query a real API now. This is the API Explorer, which is an awesome tool for learning how to use Google APIs and also is great for debugging problems. In this case, we're making a request against the YouTube data API, and we're using the YouTube.search.list method. The only parameter that I have to fill in here is, or the only parameters are part and q, which is the string that I'm looking for. If I press execute here, you can see the request that I've just made and the response, which is a JSON document with all the results that I'm looking for.
So of course, what you've seen here so far is all raw requests against the API. Now, you don't have to code everything by hand. We actually have client libraries for a number of different programming languages that make your job a lot easier by handling a lot of the boilerplate stuff, such as authentication, discovering services. Since we have so many APIs, we actually built a discovery service that lists all of them. And also other things, such as building the requests, parsing the responses, et cetera.
So here you can see examples for four different languages. As you can see, it makes the requests much easier to use than coding everything by hand, especially handling things like authentication. The first example is Java and lists the ad clients of an account. In the second example, you can get, it's a Python example that gets the ad units for a client ID. The PHP sample gets the custom channels applied to an ad unit. And the last example defines how you would configure a report in C Sharp.
So some of the important features, the most important features actually when you're doing reporting, is the ability to have your own channels. And these channels come in two types, custom channels and URL channels. The first, custom channels, are defined by you, and you can assign an ad unit or multiple ad units to a channel. And so this allows you to give specific meanings to sets of ad units. You could have, for example, a set for all of the ad units that display on the top versus all of the ad units that display on the left. Or you could assign different meanings, such as categories of the pages that you're displaying these on. In terms of the URL channels, these are actually filled in automatically depending on the URL of the page that the ads are displayed on. So in terms of authentication and authorization, the API uses the OAuth2 standard. And we support two different types of application. Web application, which handles all of the applications both from server-side and client-side perspective, and installed applications, which can go from anything from a full GUI desktop application to just a simple Python script that runs in a cron job. The AdSense Management API does not support service accounts because service accounts do not allow access to protected user data, which AdSense data is. In terms of reports, you have the full flexibility of the AdSense reports at your hand. So you can run the exact same reports that you would run on the AdSense website. This includes running a report for one or multiple ad clients, same thing for ad units, channels, et cetera. You can configure these any way you want. You can add filters, et cetera.
So if you need to fetch a report, you should check out the list of dimensions and metrics available in developers.google.com. Now, let's see an example using the APIs Explorer. In this case, I've pre-filled the date range, the dimension, which is date. I added two metrics, as you can see here. And now I can't really execute. I have to authorize first. So for that, I use this button here, click authorize, and we're good to go.
That's actually the auth2 step.
It's generated my request, and here I have the response in a JSON file or object.
So in version 1.2, we introduced a couple of new features, ad styles and saved reports. The first one allows you to get all of the styling information for an ad unit, which means colors, fonts, corners, whether they're rounded or not, and how rounded they are. And the second one, Saved Reports, allows you to run your existing reports, which are configured in the AdSense website, via the API and handle the results programmatically. In v1.3, we added a few new features as well. We added the ability to list your existing account alerts. We added metadata to reporting, which gives you the ability to list your dimensions and metrics, the dimensions and metrics that are available to your reports, as well as the relationships between them, which ones you can use, which ones you can combine and which ones you can't. And we also added the ability to generate ad code for existing ad units, so you can get the JavaScript snippets and insert them into your website.
In version 1.4, we added a call to list your payments, which was a highly requested feature. Also, now you can delete alerts, which is the same thing as dismissing them in the AdSense web interface. And finally, we added two fields to the report response, start date and end date, especially important if you're using relative dates like yesterday, start of month, today minus 1 month, etc. If you want, you can check the reporting guides to learn about this feature in developers.google.com.
So thank you for watching this video. And speaking of developers.google.com, you can find all of our documentation at developers.google.com/AdSense. You can follow our blog at googleadsdeveloper.blogspot.com. And you can follow our Google Plus page, which I'm not going to spell out, but the URL is in the slide you can see.
OK, thank you.
Thank you for watching.